go.
Leads to the Lantern King.
Yeah.
sources of power. Their stones are buried deep, connected to the flow of energy beneath the ground. Snow from the mountain shrine feeds these streams. The waters here are sacred. Thank you.
are several worn fishing baskets here. A simple design, but effective.
Children and Taro often fished in these streams, in the stillness of the forest. I can almost hear their voices.
Taro and his siblings felt safe in these woods. You taught them well, Ruthu.
We leave offerings at the Guardian Tree, asking it to protect the ones we love. Taro left this for the children. He must have been so scared when he lost them. Many of the offerings here were placed by the first village leaders. Skilled hunters who use spirit energy to create powerful weapons. I'm sure the Guardian Tree won't mind if we use them to help Taro.
Go.
I don't know what corruption waits for you in the Lantern Cave, but I suspect Taro's spirit will fight to the end.
A fox symbol is marked on this old camping gear.
You'll get it.
There.
Tomotaro's lantern. He must have lost it searching for the children.
Bring the relics to the fallen tree. It's time to help Taro find peace.
I'm going to help Taro now, but it's not safe for you here. Go with Mr. Rusu. I'll find you when Taro is free.
Be careful, Kena.
Thank you.
The sickness that took our parents was spreading through the village.
Spirits of the forest, walk with our people. Guide them on their journey to the mountain shrine.
Food was running low. Everyone was scared. I never felt so helpless. Saya wanted to stay, but I thought we could go to Rusu for help. I was sure he would know what to do. But something was not right in the woods. I had never seen Rusu so worried. He sent us back to the village. And I knew we were alone. I was all that Benny and Saya had left. I had to protect them. It happened the next morning. Explosion from the mountain shrine covered the land in darkness.
Oh no! No! Benny! Saya! Where are you?
It lasted for days. I searched everywhere for them. I was their older brother. I was supposed to protect them. Even now, it's hard to forgive myself.
Taro, the children know how much you care for them. What happened in the village wasn't your fault. You will always be their older brother, and they still need you.
I'm sorry, Kina. We can't take you to the mountain shrine.
It's okay. You have to go now.
Taro rests with his siblings now. I imagine the corruption in the forest has cleared him as well.
I know it was time for Benny and Saya to move on with their brother, but the forest won't be the same without them.
It's natural to build a connection to the spirits we help. We give up a part of ourselves when they move on. But the bond still remains. The path of a spirit guide is the only one. There is still work to be done if you wish to reach the mountain shrine. A skilled woodsmith once lived in our village and built structures beyond anyone's imagination. Search the fields beyond the storehouse for her troubled spirit.
Right there.
You're going to need more power to get that door moving. Energy has not flowed here for a long time. The land has begun to heal. Is this your doing?
My name is Kena. I helped Benny and Saya free Taro's spirit. I'm on my way to help the Woodsmith. Do you know her?
Yes, I know Adira. She was a great Woodsmith. Together, we found a way to capture the energy of the mountain shrine. She believed we could harness the resources of this land to sustain the village forever. But that dream faded long ago. We've only just met, but I can tell you have a strong connection to the spirit realm. You carry the same energy that flows through these roots. It must be what drew you to this place. With focus, you can gather that energy. Your bomb should prove useful in powering up all the old technology around here. We need to repair the power mechanisms to open the passage. Take a look up there and see if you can get things working.
Go get it.
Huh.
again!
Shit!